getting to meet people like that was extraordinary. Of, you know, people like Hans Bethe, I still remember, had, you know, this amazing, like, sparkly blue eyes, and telling the wonderful story about him telling his wife that, showing his wife the stars, and getting to tell her that he was the only one in the world that knew why they shined. And so it was pretty extraordinary people around. You know, I got to meet Stan Ulam very briefly. I didn't really know him, but he was still around then. Went out and visited him. But Metropolis was super interested in the connection machine, yeah, and really participated quite a lot in thinking about how to program it. And Dick Feynman got really interested, and he had this crazy project, which was to use quantum, basically use what we now call qubits to do quantum computing. So he was actually working on that project at Thinking Machines. Of course, it was before any of that stuff was really figured out how to work, but that was his secret project, was to make the quantum computer. So it was really a great blessing, I think, to be around all these amazing physicists. And that generation of physicists were very close to each other and tied together in an interesting way, I think partly because they'd all worked together at Los Alamos.
Yeah, through the war.
Yeah, so they were kind of a society, they were kind of a community that were very tightly knit. So once you got to know a few of them, you sort of became, I was always, a observer, but I got to know an awful lot of them, and I always thought that was a great blessing. And of course, Dick Feynman being the extreme version of that. And Philip Morrison also, very important. Nick Metropolis was very important. And then later finding out that Kistiakowsky, who, was my high school mentor, that he had been part of that. It's funny sort of how many of those people ended up influencing my life in various ways. But they really did sort of set the tone for a generation of scientists.